As the ship approached the coast of New England, a heavy fog set in. The ship's radar detected what appeared to be another ship, another vessel in its path, and so the captain sent the following message: change your course 10 degrees port, that is to say, to the left. And shortly after, they received a reply that says, change your course 10 degrees starboard, to the right. The captain became annoyed and said, I'm a lieutenant commander of the U.S. Navy. You change your course. And this was the response: I'm a seaman third class. Change your course. By now, the captain was furious, and his next message read, this is a battleship. Change your course. Moments later, a message came across the wire that said, this is a lighthouse. Change your course. You know, there are certain laws at work in the universe, and no amount of power, or money, or influence can change them. And these laws are God's laws, and He designed them to work for us, not against us. In order for this to happen, though, we sometimes have to change our course. His laws don't change. We must change. When we try to find happiness and fulfillment and meaning in life through any other method than a personal relationship with God, we're setting ourselves up for failure. But it doesn't have to be that way. The good news is we can change our course at any time. We can choose life over death. We can choose spiritual blessings over self-destruction. God doesn't change His course to accommodate us, but if we're willing to change our course, to chart the path of our lives in God's direction, He will then open His arms wide to receive us and shower us with His blessings from on high. These are His words. Listen to what He says in Deuteronomy 30, verse 19. I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. Now choose life, so that you and your children may live, and that you may love the Lord your God, listen to His voice, and hold fast to Him. For the Lord is your life. God bless you. In Jesus' name is my prayer.